So being on the national team is a pretty incredible experience. What you get to do is pretty amazing. So getting to go like to all these competitions at different parts of the world, meet all these incredible people that are, you know, from other countries on their national teams, are as psyched as you are, dedicated as you are. And obviously like competing, I had some decent results and stuff, but the results kind of were, you know, almost equal to just how fun the trips were.
Will is very, very motivated on particular things, and he will put a lot of energy, discipline, commitment into what he does. And I think he is right up there amongst some of the very strongest climbers in the world.
The competitions were like my life. It was kind of everything that I dedicated my training to and like fully focused on. And then all of a sudden this year it just wasn't, which has been like a crazy big change. Obviously, like I'm pretty young, only 23, and I've decided like probably not to do comps anymore, and there's been like a lot of reasons for that.
I wasn't entirely surprised when Will said he was stepping away from competitions. Physically and technically, Will is world class, and I think he would have potential to podium basically at every single event. Maybe the part of him which hasn't come so easy has been the mental side of competitions, and particularly on the, I'd say, the deep underlying motivations towards competition. I'd have these conversations with him, even in the middle of competition season, and the energy level would be 5 out of 10. But then we would switch to talking about, I don't know, a limestone project outside locally, and he'd be like 9 out of 10 straight away, even in competition season. But Will being Will, he was still incredibly disciplined and got on with the competition things, and he did amazing considering that tear his psyche and motivation.
So by the end after Moscow, everything had kind of like got too much, and I knew that I just had to change something or just stop, so I decided I would. Outdoor climbing was definitely like this sort of big change. Like everything sort of didn't matter that mattered with the competition scene. So it was always very relaxing and enjoyable, and you could really like focus on different things. I think there's like obviously a correlation between sort of slowly leaving the team and my performance outdoor getting better, but I think it is mixed in a bit where obviously I was training really, really hard all the way through to try and qualify for the Olympics. And then when I like missed out in Toulouse and was absolutely devastated, I realised that like I needed to change something. So I went and decided to train in more of like an outdoor setting in Spain. And like in that time, obviously like I was training really hard, so I was getting like a really good form, and then started sending these really hard routes because I was putting time into them as well.
Will was like this boiling pot of kind of energy and frustration and psych for outdoor climbing that was just getting more and more frothy all the way through the competition season. And as soon as it was kind of over and done with, he just kind of went with it as soon as he went on that trip. And when I saw the tick list that came back from it, I was thinking, that's freaking brilliant.
He changed as a person, basically. He was happy every day, psyched to go outside, no matter what the problem was, even if it was the dirtiest route you've ever seen. His motivation came back, his climbing style changed. It was just so, so cool to witness.
Having time to focus on mutation, he finally got the job done, which is amazing to think really that a route that is as literally as old as Will has taken this long for somebody to come along and repeat it.
So with my climbing, I've always been really interested and excited to try things that are sort of mystery and are a bit unknown, and in the UK I've found a few things which have been exciting to try. but then the one place it's always stuck out in my head I've always wanted to go and sort of explore was the Czech Republic. I've been like looking at these the odd photo and video that Adam and Martin Stranick have posted from the Czech Republic for like 5 to 10 years and just being like always thinking like, wow, that actually looks really interesting, really cool, but there's like no information about it. Like, you know, one of the hardest routes in the world is in the Czech Republic and no one's ever gone to try it. You know, like there's so much like mystery and stuff around the Czech that I was so psyched to actually go and check it out. But I never felt that I had the time because I felt like I had to go for a decent length of trip. So I was like, well, hang on, I've actually got time, I can do this. I could plan a long trip and I'll just train really hard for this trip. Trained the whole winter all the way through just straight for it and like to get like in the I guess the strongest shape of my life probably, I'm pretty sure.
Moravský Kras is a limestone area northeast of Brno. There's few cracks, some of them are very chossy. Somewhere the rock quality is pretty good, but what is definitely all the cracks have in common is that the rock is zero friction limestone. It's really bouldery, fingery, the feet are really slippery, and most people don't really like climbing around here.
Yeah, I was absolutely blown away by some of the climbing, like especially some of the holds.
In general, a lot of the holds are quite different. Instead of just getting really grim crimps, they're actually really nice slopers and like pretty perfect pinches, and the feet as well are all quite rounded.
When I knew that he was going to be meeting up and climbing with Adam, I was over the moon because I felt like over the last couple of years, Will's been a little bit of a dark horse, almost I think perhaps in his own mind, not quite knowing what his capacity was. And I felt like if he could stand right next to Adam, side by side, and see how he related to him, he would go, oh my goodness, I am capable of so much more. And I think you've seen quite a big change since that event.
There's basically no information about the Czech Republic in terms of a lot of the climbing there. Everyone knows there's a lot of hard climbs, but no one knows what they are, what the holds are like. So there's so much mystery around it, and that was one of the big things that drew me towards it.
Not even people from Prague would dare traveling to Moravský Kras to climb here, because they would think it's not worth it, 2.5 hours. I immediately told all my friends, like, oh, somebody is coming, Will Bosi is coming to Moravian Kars. And then, yeah, he came, indeed.
The country's awesome. I really enjoyed my time there, and the climbing like completely blew my mind. I didn't expect it to be anywhere near as much as there was. There was one boulder I did, which if it was a standalone block with a top out in Switzerland, there would always be queues to try it. It was so good. The holds were incredible. The moves amazing, and you're like, it's only because it's at this unknown limestone crack in the Czech Republic that no one really comes for it. But the boulder's actually amazing.
I was kind of expecting that, yes, I knew that he's super strong in the crimpers, and I knew that he would be crushing all the boulders, and that's pretty much what happened into like an incredible extent. Like, it was super impressive to see.
The Czech Republic was, I'd say, his first official trip as an outdoor climber. He'd left the comps behind him, he wasn't coming back, and it was amazing, to be honest. pairing of Will and Adam climbing together was amazing to witness because they're both so psyched and so motivated. And I think it's one of the happiest I've ever seen Will, just fully in his element, trying his hardest, climbing his hardest, and with great company too. So I think it was definitely one of the best trips we've ever been on.
The route climbing was just on another level there. I got two routes done, which I was really psyched with. It doesn't sound like a lot, but when you have kind of the best climber in the world putting them up, they're all pretty savagely sandbagged.
Most of the boulders are repeated or at least tried. Most of my routes are somehow neglected. So I was really happy that he found the time to try some of my sport routes and repeated Kostěně Smrtelný and Vedla Východu.
I'm just there at the crag and, you know, Adam's like, was chatting, and, oh yeah, I did this when I was 14. I'm just like, oh my God, that's ridiculous. That route took me so many days and I thought it was so hard that even if it was 9A plus, I would not, like, it wouldn't get downgraded. Like every route I tried another route that he had originally given 8C and it's been upgraded to 8C plus. He was hesitant about saying that. And I was like, it's desperate. It's absolutely desperate, you know? And I think like with the boulders there, you know, the grades are all seem quite okay because there's been Martin Stranick trying them or repeating them as well, but the routes, they've just all gone unrepeated and no one's, I guess, put a lot of time into the grades are all pretty stiff. Climbing free at last at Dumbarton was absolutely amazing for me. Closing the chapter on the last one, maybe 2 years of my life, where it had gone through the exiting the competition scene, where it had been very stressful, and then moving into a period of exploration, and then forward into now, where it's just being so excited about, you know, all these projects I've got in mind, and yeah, I'm very excited for what's going to come next.